Good afternoon and welcome to night two of Puggyland's Global Cooking Challenge as we cook more food from the Seychelles. Tonight we're going to be doing a different Seychelles fish curry and doing a Creole papaya salad, a green papaya salad to go with that, and there's kind of a story behind that. But again, if you're wondering where the Seychelles are, we're looking right about there, off the coast of Kenya, between near Comoros and Madagascar. So it's a very small series of islands, 115 little islands off the coast of Africa. So without further ado, let's... Hello, we're doing glasses this time, and we're not doing fisheye lens. There we go. So we're listening to music from the Seychelles, which is a little more traditional Seychelles music than we had music on Sunday, because then it was more of New Age music for the lounge set, which is rather big, as the Seychelles is a large beach resort nation, and much of its income is derived from tourism. So, Mariana, my good friend, how are you? So good seeing you. Let me get you some juice here. How you doing? Welcome back. Yes, we are cooking the food at Seychelles for night two. Again, we're doing a green papaya salad, and I forgot to bring my paper. Just a moment. And another fish curry, which uses a particular... spice mix, which is kind of the key to this recipe. Joe, thank you for the like and follow. Is that Joe? I think it's Joe. Yes, it is Joe Hart. How you doing? Thank you. Thank you for the follow. Yes, it has been a while. Just a moment. I am a little parched here. It's been a day. I did my 10 miles this morning, and I'm zonked. I was so zonked. I forgot to run the dishwasher when I was asleep, which is that noise we're hearing over there for the next 20 minutes. Oops. Okay, so the deal is, I wanted to do a different dish. I wanted to do an octopus salad. And I got all the ingredients I needed for it except for the octopus. And the deal with octopus is that you need to have either the whole octopus, which is usually frozen, almost exclusively you get it frozen, or you have to let that defrost over 24 hours, and I didn't go get it yesterday. And option two is baby octopus, and I thought I could easily get baby octopus at the fish market, and they only had it pre-made in a salad with teriyaki and stuff, which is not what I was looking for. So I looked someplace else, I called around, didn't work, they had it frozen by the pound, I didn't need that much. So I went plan B with the green papaya salad. So that's where we're at. So we're gonna start by peeling and cleaning our green papaya. Green papaya, not the same as your regular papaya. That's one right there. So we're gonna peel and clean that sucker and put it in a bowl. Let's do the big one. On the peeler. So how's everybody been? Recovering from traveling. Margot! Is that Margot? Margot's updates. Hello, hey, how you doing? Thanks for coming by. Thanks for joining us. We are cooking the food of the Seychelles for the second night. Again, tonight we're cooking a green papaya salad, green papaya, and a fish curry. So, starting with peeling this sucker. Hopefully this is gonna work. I didn't actually peel a green papaya before, I don't think. I've done green papaya a couple times. Generally, I found it in Southeast Asian dishes. It's kind of surprising to find it in something that's not. Hey, Lydia, thank you for liking the restream. Thank you for the restream, Marietta. Sounds good. Thank you. The green papaya is really tasty. And I have a friend who's like, I can't deal with papaya. It's just a flavor I can't stand. And I'm telling him, try green papaya. It's like a different thing. I don't know if it's a completely unrelated fruit. But it is a completely different flavor. Papaya, your orange papaya, regular ripe papaya, or whatever you want to call it, is has a kind of a mushy taste. It's the only way I can describe it. Well, the green papaya is kind of fresher. And, you know, I learned a trick that I'm not using right now. I should use it. I bought whole octopus once, but I didn't know how to prep cook it. Yeah, there are some good hints online about how to, this is the trick to hold it with a paper towel. There's a WikiHows on how to, footballers, thank you for the restream. There are tips online as to how to work with octopus, a whole octopus. The goal is to, thank you for the hearts, footballers. I am doing better. I'm doing better. Thank you for asking. Just tired. And a little frustrated from not finding the octopus, which I'm discussing here. The baby octopus, anyway. But cooking regular octopus, and I did this for Portugal. I'm trying to put the old videos, at least the ones that were captured, on my new YouTube channel, in addition to all the ones that were catched. Those are on my catch page, which is now linked from the main page. Jorgen, thank you for the like and the restream. But I was thinking about octopus. The key there is to make it so it's not rubbery. And apparently, you want frozen octopus. I like your sporangia. Oops, apron. Yes. Thank you. From the fine folks at the Funky Fairy. Say that three times fast. At meerkattees.com. They are wonderful. We love them. They are our favorite people in the world. So buy t-shirts and meerkat merchandise from them. They have emoji cushions and such now even. So check them out. Really nice people. And they send anywhere in the world, it seems. The hearts were from Lydia. Give her credit. Yes, Lydia. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Lydia. Lydia's the hearts lady. Thank you. I don't have a set of glasses, Lydia. I only have one. That would have many as yours. That would set me back a ways. Oh yes, I follow them. Yes, they're wonderful. Okay, we peeled our green papaya here. I'm gonna need to take pictures. That's for the blog. Hold on. The blog is at cliffyland.com, just add a .com at the end, and you'll find pictures, links to the recipes, how to, kind of how it all went. Yes, Lydia is great. And like my first place I go every morning. Check out everything there. Videos are there. Everything you need is there. So, cliffyland.com. It's on Twitter, on Tumblr, on Facebook, on Instagram, on Pinterest, now on YouTube, just everywhere. So look for us, find, follow here on Meerkat, everything. About the octopus, back to what I was saying. I wanted to cook, but I didn't cook. Octopus, you will find it frozen, and you want it frozen. Anywhere you go, you're going to get it frozen, and it's better to have it frozen anyway. But you have to defrost it over a period of 24 hours, like in the fridge or in some water. And then you go through the process of either boiling it or frying it and such. But there are some WikiHows up there. Just Google how to prepare octopus, and it'll let you know. Okay, so we're going to cut this in half. This is going to get loud once I get it chopped up here. So green papaya, gonna cut you in half. This does not feel like an octopus, like a... This would kill me if I wound up having bought like entirely the wrong thing. That would be really embarrassing. I think this might wind up being embarrassing. It feels embarrassing. It feels very, very embarrassing. Because I think I've gone completely in the wrong direction. I think I've gone completely and totally in the wrong direction. Because here's the deal. I couldn't find the octopus. I couldn't find the baby octopus. So I got frustrated. And I bought an avocado. Not a green papaya. It had green papaya, like, on a sign right on top of it. So, I'm dumb. But there was an assist. There was a dumb assist. There was assist in the dumbness. So, we're making avocado salad! Surprise! What type of music is that in the background? It is the Splendor de l'Océan Indien. The Splendor of the Indian Ocean. And this is Cyril Labaron. This is off of Apple Music. So, Splendor de les Îles de l'Océan Indien. So, Splendor of the Indian Ocean. Goof. Oh yes, you are in the same city, in both in Vancouver. So I'm a goof, I'm an idiot, I'm a moron, I'm dope, but I have peeled me an avocado. So I guess we're making an avocado salad. That should be interesting. I tell you, a green avocado, a green papaya looks a lot like it. It does. Surprise. Look at me making a fool of myself on live on the internet. Okay, so we are not going to run the green papaya through the food processor since it's not a papaya. So what am I gonna do? I'm going to try to slice it small and hope that that will work. Wow. How embarrassing. Avocado salad sounds good. Yes, it does sound good. You can never go wrong with avocado. Yeah. Yep. Now the avocado, this is obviously a Florida type avocado, as opposed to the California avocado, which is small, like, you know, like wrinkly. That adds to my rationalization for my goof. But instead of green papaya, we're gonna do avocado, and we're just gonna hope it works. You can't fry an avocado, can you? I'm gonna have to take some steps out of the... It's supposed to be warm salad, not a cold salad. You can't fry avocado, it's cold. Ah, boy, this is gonna be all kinds of, yes, it's a huge avocado. The Florida ones are rather big. Wow. Wowzers. Let's taste this, eh? God, I'm so stupid. Tastes good. Yummy. Yummy even. Quite yummy. Golly. What am I gonna do? Well, here's the thing. This salad has onions and such that's all warm. Nice to know about the roots, and it's always nice to meet people who meet on Meerkat. Yes. Awesome. Okay. So I'm trying to figure out what to do with my goof, with my goof, goofity goofness. Because it has stuff that's hot, and then we'd otherwise add the green papaya, which is not green papaya. So I guess I'm gonna cook that and put aside and then make it cold and hope it works. I'm just gonna really hope at this point. This is gonna be like improvisation here. Salad improv 101. Always follow the yes if you've ever taken improv class. Well then, into the bowl you go. That needs to be smaller. Yes. Boy. No, avocado pieces. They're not getting cooked. They're getting mixed in with the other stuff. This happens when I come up with stuff, like, on the fly. Because I was in such a panic. I was at the fish market. When they handed me the pre-prepped baby octopus, I said, no. I went out in the parking lot and started Googling Seychelles salad recipes, and I kept landing on the same octopus recipe. And then I landed on this one. And of course, I'm so dumb. I'm so dumb. Well, we're gonna figure it out. So we've got avocado now. Lots and lots of avocado. Wow. Really buttery. So it's gonna have onions and peppers, chili peppers, and we're gonna see how that works. It could be good, it could be bad. We're gonna find out. Thank you for the like and the restream. I am my son. Thank you. Ergo. So, chopped pieces of avocado. Well, let me just wash my hands here. You know, once before I picked something I was entirely wrong about what I got. It was the time I thought I had a sweet potato, and after I peeled it, I discovered it was just a regular potato that just looked like a sweet potato and was labeled the wrong way in the market. So, we're gonna peel the onion. So it's gonna be onion and chili pepper and sunflower oil and chili. So here goes nothing. Let's go with the onion. Oh God, very little onion even. I'm gonna get my scale. So, Vicky, thanks for the like and the restream. Love you. Selling aprons for you. If you're just catching up, I have totally gone off the deep end. It was supposed to be a Creole green papaya salad. I bought the thing that I thought was green papaya. It turned out to be avocado. Surprise. So now we are improvising the avocado salad. Anthony, hello. How you doing? I hope I didn't miss anybody in the conversation back and forth there. It says like one, this is all metric. But it said like 1.1 ounce of onion. Very little onion. So I'm just gonna do half an onion. We are improvising like crazy here at Pledgey Land. Throwing all the wind into the caution. So I have half an onion that I saved. I don't even care anymore. Veal Fitness, is that right? V Fitness, thank you for the like there. How you doing? Okay, let's see if this onion is livable. or if I should just chuck it. Because it said to use like ridiculously little onion to fry this onion. This was a weird recipe. Because it strikes me as initially intended as a warm salad. It's going to wind up being a cold salad. This stuff has gotten previously cooked. And we're just going to hope that that works. So this is a new, and I'm going entirely the wrong way, aren't I? This is opposite day here. Oh, I'm such a mess. I am a huge ass mess today. I was just really upset when I went. They didn't have the octopus, and they said, oh, the baby octopus we have when it's in season. I was thinking, I didn't know there was a season for baby octopus. Hey, Kenneth, hello. Oh, no, yes, it's Kenneth. Thank you for the like and the restream there. If you're just joining us, cooking Seychelles night two, allegedly doing a green papaya salad. Turned out we did not buy green papaya. I thought about green papaya, got into it, turned out it was an avocado. It's supposed to be a warm salad, and I don't think I can fry avocado. Because I've never seen that done, it's probably not a good idea. Ergo, I think I am going to do everything I would normally do for the green papaya salad and then put it in the fridge with the avocado and hope for the best. We're gonna explore new things. If you are from the Seychelles and you are here and you are seeing this and you are at some point in the future looking at this on YouTube and going, who is this lunatic? Thinks he can cook our food and substitute an avocado. Hi. That's me. Okay, so we've got our chopped onion. It said really ridiculously little chopped onion. And, I mean, I converted it from the metric and it struck me as very, very odd. Not using your Chinese clip. Yeah, not at the moment. I have it, but I didn't sharpen it. It gets stuff all over the place. I have been using it though, so you just haven't been here to see it. Rest assured, it's there. Okay, onion. Now we're gonna get a chili pepper and crush it. And again, it said green chili pepper. I, again, stupidly forgot to buy the optional green onion. Haha, you hilarious man, you are no lunatic. Well, thank you. Okay, we got our mortar and pestle from Cliff, so I just looked it up. It's okay to fry avocado. Website says you can, but bread it first. Whoa. That's an additional level of something. Breading it? Like with flour? I think I'm gonna stick with a cold option. But I will keep that in mind for some other future situation. Because that's just one other level of difference. So, chili pepper. It said green chili pepper, and it turns out I don't have green chili pepper. I have, where are you? Had it in my hand. I have some aging bird's eye chilies. That's a recipe of deep fried avocado taco. Whoa. That would be interesting. That's for the Guy Fieri feed, right? Well, get in there. I don't want to have to touch it too much because I don't have to put on the gloves. So I've got a couple chilies that are not completely dead yet. So we'll take you. I'm just gonna take two. Oh, these need to go. These need to go. I'm gonna take two small of these and then chuck the rest. deep fried avocado taco. This is all gonna go away. Going away. And we are saving the two little stragglers here. This is so improv it hurts. I am really hoping my hands don't. I need to put on the gloves. Just put on the gloves. I'm getting a run out of gloves here. Okay. Gotta get back to work. Catch you later, Cliff. Have a good one. Yes, you too, footballers. Be well. Live long and prosper. I'll give you the hand signal here. Live long and prosper. Whatever that is. The rubbery Spock. Okay. Wow. What a day. I was really all prepared to do the octopus thing, and I have everything else I need for the octopus salad. It was gonna have this nice dressing of honey and stuff. Not to be. It was not to be. So we've crushed our red Thai chili. I'm putting that aside. I don't have to mess up another bowl for that. I don't know why I put on the gloves for that. I guess because I touched the peppers. Wow. Gotta get I'm looking at an omelet with avocados. Interesting. I guess I could see that. I feel like I wasted using the gloves. But in any case, here goes. We're just gonna go to the short cooking portion. I'm gonna go to the saute pan, because there isn't much here. And I will move you, and not the avocado. That would be weird. I'm still very nervous about the prospect of fried avocado, just like, I think that would be a big mess. I need water. Okay. Both these recipes. D-Skills. Thank you for the like and the restream. David Dorian, my good man. Dizzle, hey buddy, how you doing? Was seeing you jamming out right before I was like going to see my stream. I was thinking, I would watch, but I gotta get moving. So, keep on rocking in the free world, my good man. Keep the old school alive. It's not enough of it. Especially up around where I am. You should hear what I hear around. It's classic rock hell up here. Fried avocado I've had baked. Yeah, I know. See, I'm not. It was supposed to be green papaya. Actually, it was supposed to be an octopus salad, but then I couldn't find. Couldn't get the frozen octopus yesterday, and I was thinking try the baby octopus today to make the green papaya salad instead of the full grown octopus, and that way I could only get half a pound. But then what I could find in the store was already prepared in a salad with teriyaki, and I couldn't like wash that off or anything. So I said, well, nix the avocado, the octopus, because I called like three different places and they didn't have it, or they had a whole frozen pound of it, which again, I couldn't defrost. This place I went to had another whole frozen octopus, again, no good. So I Googled for green papaya salad, went to the store, saw the regular papaya, saw on top of it what appeared to be green papaya with the big sign that said papaya. I bought it and it opened it up and it's an avocado. I'm okay. It's all a little under the weather, so it wasn't as good as I wanted it at all, but thank you, my friend. Yeah, you can hear the voice. I'm still kind of overcoming the bug or whatever that I got 2 weeks ago. So, here goes. So, the end of the story is that not making the octopus salad and not making green papaya salad as I expected, because I did not buy a green papaya, which I did not find out till I opened the damn thing and said, it's a Florida avocado, not a California avocado. It fooled me. They look similar to these bad eyes. So, that's the deal. Good chi going your way. Whatever that is. Okay, so we're... both these recipes call for sunflower oil, and I went to the market, and I'll be damned if there was only one brand of sunflower oil that I could buy. Which I'm sure is fine, but I don't like having only one choice. So, both these recipes call for sunflower oil. So we're heating that up, and we're going to fry the onions and the chili, which would have been a green chili, but I didn't have it. So this is like way, way off recipe. Off recipe. You're creating here, which is not really my goal here on the challenge, but sometimes it just happens. Hi, please try to listen to an audio Bible Christian programming. No, thank you. Please go away. Go away. Thank you, so good to share it my way as us. The worst avocado is the Florida variety. Some people have different feelings about that. I mean, that's what I grew up eating, the Florida one, because that was all in the backyard. Everyone was like wanting to buy it. And, you know, I kind of like it. I'm not a huge avocado, you know, connoisseur, so I couldn't really tell you. But, you know, I kind of like them. So here goes the ultimate pic, the umpty-umpt picture of onions being fried. I am the owner of the world's largest collection of onions being dropped into a pan. You did not know that. It's true. It's true. And let's add in these these chilies. Hold on, I need to take a picture. Don't fall, don't fall, don't fall. But yeah, those avocados, Florida avocados, look very different than your California avocados. They fooled me. I was saying I totally goofed the time earlier when I thought I had a sweet potato. It was just... here I'm taking pictures, and what do you know? It's not a sweet potato at all. But that was back in, I don't know, Fiji or something. So what are we doing? We're cooking it till soft, and we would be adding the green papaya once these are soft, but I'm not adding the avocado here, because that does not seem right at all. It would say add lemon to it after it's cooked, but I think I'm going to mix it in the bowl. Once this is softened, mix it in the bowl with the avocado. Let it cool. Mix it in the bowl with the avocado and add lemon and cover it and then just put it away and call that a day. Oh, see, salt and pepper too. And we're gonna see what the heck happens. We're gonna find out together. Could be utter disaster. We never know. I really didn't plan on doing a second dish. In fact, the only reason I started this early, which is quite early, because I'm slow with the prep, and there's like, for the second dish, there's a fair amount of prep, but the cook is like that. The cook is 10 minutes long. So last time I said, oh, the cook is, you know, on Sunday, if you tuned in. Santos, thanks for the restream. Last time I cooked on Sunday, I said, the cook is really fast. I'll start at whatever, and then we didn't wind up eating till like 8:30. Hola, ¿cómo te va? ¿Cómo está cosa por aquí? Déjame decirte, aquí en el mercado latino, la gente son... No son muy amables. I said, I went to the Latin market here, where I got the papaya, which was not a papaya, which was an avocado. But I'll be damned, there are two separate Latin markets here. I thought there was only one. And I'll be damned if in both of them, they are like not friendly people at who work at the store. I am like, you know, chatting, I'm asking friendly and no, not happy to be there at all. Sometimes that happens. Okay, this seems golden, softened, and such. So obviously the onion is for kind of a sweetening agent. Things I'm learning as I go. So I'm gonna take this off the damn heat. I'm gonna let this cool, and then I'm gonna mix it in with a lot. Hope I didn't just magically make it overcook. And I'm also feeling that pepper in my mouth. That's some spicy. But spicy is good. Do they know who you are? Do they know who you are? Cute. Martina, hello. Thank you for the like and the restream. And thank you for your help on Sunday, too. That was very, very helpful. Today we are doing a high wire act for me. That's a low wire act for anyone else. Oh my God, I have that pepper in my mouth. Supposed to be octopus salad. Didn't find the octopus. Made a green papaya salad. Cut it open. Turned out not green papaya. Turned out it was Florida avocado. Surprise! So, we are improvising. We're gonna make this a avocado salad. You're welcome. Thank you. Okay, lemon. I don't know how long that's gonna take to cool. I'm gonna put the lemon in here now. Okay. Lemon. Okay, we got lemon. What am I looking for? Lemon juicer. Right here. Where's the chips? Oh, for guacamole. Yeah, that would be a different country. Wow. I'm not, you know, making my own. How was your fish and rice dish Sunday? Let me tell you, they came out really well. Oh, by the way, I cook live. Thank you for the follow. Anyone you can follow right there, here, or follow Meerkat. Get notifications of when the streams are scheduled and they're going to start and all that good stuff. Fish Sunday. It was really, really good. It was really, this light makes my hair look really weird. It was really, really good. And it was packed with flavor. The curry was really fantastic. It was just fantastic. The rice was also very good. We're having that as leftovers alongside the fish tonight. I had a little bit of leftovers for it yesterday for lunch. It was good. I'm a little worried that it's gonna be either too dry or too mushy, but we're gonna, try to be careful. I'm gonna add water to it, but not too much. So we're gonna see how that goes. Cause I don't need to make more rice when I have leftover Creole rice from Sunday. So lemon juice, here we go. Take a picture of you. Boy, what a mess. Okay. You know, I think those things are funny when I mean, not now, but usually the last time I had like a huge oopsie, it was like the record most people watching at once. Everyone's watching me throw something right in the garbage. Probably not today. Good stuff, yes, okay. So lemon on the avocado. I'm gonna taste one. Good. Good with lemon. Oh, that's actually very good. Good. Okay, here goes nothing. We've got our onions and chili pepper, which is as cool as it's gonna get right now. Yummy. I'm gonna add you to the avocado. Focus, damn it. Thank you. Okay. In you go. This is actually pretty good. I like this. Usually when I do the music of a certain country, It's okay. Well, sometimes it's annoying. But only once before did I find something I wanted so bad I actually went out and, you know, bought it. A little salt and pepper. Yes, I am doing that next. I can find no closed fishing season for octopus except the Puget Sound area on the West Coast. Yeah. I don't understand. Well, people say that to me. Like, oh, it's not season. I'm not knowing. I just go, okay. Let me tell you. The first time I was like way back in the A's, a recipe called for spring onions. I now know that a spring onion is a relative of the scallion slash green onion, and they can be substituted, but they're not exactly the same. That being said, I went in, I said, do you have spring onions? And they said, no, it's not spring. We get them in the spring. And I was like, okay. They were wrong, they lied to me. People do that, and they can get away with it, because I don't know. When I do know, then they can't get away with it. So we're gonna season this sucker up and toss. And that's what we're gonna do. Diana, do I see Diana? Yes, hello, Diana. Salt and pepper, and then we'll toss and we'll taste. Okay, and I didn't take a picture. Say cheese. Come on, focus. Thank you. Okay. And then we'll taste. Thank you for the restream, Diana. So let's toss this sucker up. I'm wondering, this probably doesn't have to go into a separate bowl. I actually thought spring onion is the same as green onion scallion. They're almost the same. If you look at them, they're almost the same, except when you look at the bottom, where the stems are, a spring onion is a little bulby. That's too much. Wet pepper? Rather than say that they were out, they say out of season. Yes. Yes, they do. Okay, I'm gonna tell this joke thing that I may have mentioned if you heard me back in St. Kitts and Nevis, but it's partly related to this. So, TV show from the 80s, early 90s called 30-something. If you haven't heard of it, check it out. But these two women, you know, they were baby boomers and, you know, feeling a little, as they were getting older, they walk into the store, record store. They had those back then. And they're playing NXS, Suicide Blonde, which was a hit at the time, and she's saying, Suicide Blonde, Concrete Blonde, there's just too many blonde music. Do they have brunette music? Excuse me, sir, I'm looking for Joan Armatrading. And the guy says, I think she's on break. So, the way clerks can, you know, goof, try to... Anyway, love that show. Yes, I miss it. I used to watch it on reruns again, and then I didn't. Okay. Here goes. That's tasty. I like it. Yay! Diana, I'm glad you liked it. It's like one of my favorite stories. Especially when I tell people who Joan Armatrading is, and she's one of my favorite artists that most people don't know about. So, now we have avocado salad. So, here come the magic lily pads. You've seen them before, you see it, you know it, you love it. The magic lily pad. Ooh. Into the fridge you go. Lol. Lols for everyone. Okay. It is 5:45. Come on, you're making everyone hungry. Thank you. Okay. I am a slow cook. I don't know if I'm this or better than the green papaya. It tastes good. It does taste quite good, and it's gonna be cold, so I won't have to worry about having it on the stove and overheating or whatever, so. Okay, well, might as well get going on our fish curry. Let me clean this off first, because this could drive me all nuts. I'll be right back. Thank you for the like, I cook alive. I have not, I must, assuming you do cook live, I need to see your stream. I need to follow you. I need to click on your name and follow you right there. Okay. Use lemon on the cob. Yes, I did. I did use lemon on the avocado. It tasted good. That's all I can tell you. It tasted good. But I did. I did use lemon on the avocado. Is something bad gonna happen? Should I know about this? It's got like turnal brown on me or something? Chemical reactions I'm not familiar with until it happens to me. Otherwise, well, then I did. So it was a good thing I put lemon on it. Yay! Okay, thank you. I thought the opposite was gonna happen. I was afraid the opposite would happen. Thank you for the tip. Okay, here we go. So we are making, this is the key to this particular dish, the Seychelles Fish Curry, that there is a spice mix, which is, excuse me, which is particular to, no, you need lemon. Well, I did use lemon, so thank you. That the spice mix is particular to the Seychelles, and you'll find it in most dishes from the Seychelles, at least most of the ones that I found anyway. And it is called Masale? No, the accent's on the E at the end. Something, it's masale. Lime juice will taste great as well. Good. Don't they do that for, isn't that what they put in for the guacamole, I think? I'm usually too busy in conversation. Surprise! When I'm at the restaurant, they're making the guacamole right next to me. I should pay attention. I should shut this trap. Okay, this one involves me possibly making a mess all over this counter for one reason. And so we may have more comedy ensue. Because when I asked the husband to get me coriander seeds at the Indian market, he brought back this many. It's as big as my head. And that's a lot of coriander seeds. This is gonna be a long time before I get through all these. But the bag is sealed. And you know what happens. When you open a bag of seeds, they go all over the damn counter. No matter how hard you try to make it not so. And I don't have a receptacle that's quite the right size for that. Ergo, storage bag is going to have to do. Okay, to keep it sealed. Okay, here goes. I'm gonna freeze part. This? The seeds in the freezer? Really? Okay, you're gonna need to tell me why. I'll do it, but I would like to know why. Anyway, meantime, 2 tablespoons. Until you tell me why, I will do that. But put these 2 tablespoons of coriander seeds. There goes one. Hello. We'll get to you later. One. Okay, picture time. Focus. Okay, 2 tablespoons of coriander seeds. Okay. Incidentally, coriander seeds, for those who don't know, is the seeds from the cilantro plant. So if you see a recipe, this is something that happened to me. See a recipe that calls for cilantro? Calls for coriander, and it looks like they're talking about an herb. They're talking about cilantro. So, this in the freezer? Someone explain to me, please. Because I had no plans on doing that. I was going to put them in a jar and put them in the spice, in the world of spices. So, put them in the freezer, but I hope I remember that they're there. That's going to be important. Okay. Well, I'm going to put it in the freezer now. You can tell me later what. But they won't stay there. Like, I put the rice in the freezer because to kill anything that might have, you know, been up in there before. But back to this. Coriander seeds. Next, we're going for cumin seeds. And I just bought me some cumin seeds. Right here, cumin. Because if you were watching on Sunday, when I ran out of curry powder, I had to have the husband run out and get some more of that. Jezume, thank you for the follow. The seeds will have... Seeds have volatile oils. Wow, okay. Interesting. Oh, by the way, I wanted to make sure I follow I Cook Live here. There. Okay. Meanwhile, backed up. Volatile oils. Okay, good to know. Meanwhile. Oh boy, I smelled that already. Cumin seeds. Comino. Comino en el español. 2 teaspoons. No, it is. Ouch. Back in you go. Not tablespoons, teaspoons. Teaspoon. Volatile oils. Will it explode on me? Will they... Do they go off easily if you anger them? Or the coriander seeds on steroids? Will they choke a player? Okay. 1 teaspoon coriander seeds. 2 teaspoon cumin seeds. Anyway, I had the husband go out and buy more curry powder. And then it had been suggested I could make my own. And I thought, oh, that's great. And then looked at the ingredients and said, oops, I don't have cumin seeds. And he came back with cumin, but it was ground cumin, which is not really exactly what I wanted. They evaporate. Okay. I'm gonna have to make a... I hope the cumin seeds don't also. Wow, really? I have to make like a spreadsheet for like where my different things are hiding in the freezer. I had volatile oils once, that was not a fun evening. Thank you, Rob. Cumin seeds, okay, black peppercorns. I'm gonna find those suckers. Because I know they're here. I know you're hiding here somewhere. Here we go. Black, whole buck. Why do you keep taking pics? It all goes for a blog, which is at cliffyland.com. You'll see pictures of everything, how it's made, links to the recipes, kind of taste of how it went, information about the countries in question, and links to these videos right here now. Also, that's why I'm taking pictures. Niels, thank you for the restream. Rob, my good man, love you guys. Love seeing your Snapchat. Snapchat. A sort of celebrity followed me on Snapchat today. I was like, what? If you have a vacuum sealing machine that works as well. You know, we had back in the 70s, we had one of those. But I like kept playing with it and the bags were really expensive. So after we ran out of bags, it was like, okay, yes. So, but at the blog, you can, cliffyland.com. You can see all the countries going back to Afghanistan. See how it started me not knowing how to boil water to this. So that's that. Back to this. 2 teaspoons of black peppercorns. I hope I have enough. And, okay, picture time. 2 teaspoons. I'm getting a reflection of myself. I will send you a DM later. Okay, good. Thank you, Diana. 1, to, yes, if you follow on Twitter, I can follow you back if you need to direct message me on something. If you follow me on Twitter, also you get links to the videos. Sent a DM for you to look at later. Great! I heard it go ding. I will look at it. Meanwhile, vacuum bags work great for marinating. Yes, and that sous vide. I tried to do, I think it was for Kenya. I had the steak, and either it was when I cooked Kenya or when I tried to use the leftovers. I tried to reheat it with a sous vide, but I didn't have like a vacuum bag. I'm gonna send you a DM too, not sure what about yet. I love you guys, I swear. Okay, 1 teaspoon cardamom pods. I do know now the cardamom pods, they're different kinds. I have one which will last forever and ever and ever, and I know it's not gonna last forever and ever and ever. I have green cardamom pods I have left over from previously. And so we're going with 1 teaspoon of these. Make sure I get the teaspoons and not the tablespoons. Ay, Dios mío. Frog won't get out of my throat. You know I see frogs every day. See big, big frogs always jumping out of my path every time I run. I try not to step on them. I also see bunny rabbits. Hector, thank you for the like. At this point, we are creating our spice mix for the Seychelles fish curry, which I believe is called masale. So, green cardamom pods, 1 teaspoon. Didn't say green necessarily, but this is the one that we have. In you go. And 1 teaspoon of cloves. Let's put you away. I hope these green cardamom pods don't have angrily volatile oils. I said about what I looked up on storing spices. Yes. And I'm trying to alphabetize these, if you can believe it. Okay, cloves. Cloves, where are you? Whole cloves. Not too many. 1 teaspoon. That seems like a lot of cloves. That is a heck of a lot of cloves. Have you ever tasted cloves? Have you did when I was in college, I don't know, you probably this happened to anybody else, but when I was in college, in theater, all these cool kids thought that it was so cool to smoke clove cigarettes back in the green room. Oh my god. Que pete. Oh, that was the most foul smell. Put me off cloves forever. But here we go with cloves anyway. Dang it. Okay. Come on. Okay. Cloves. And a small piece of cinnamon. I have more cinnamon sticks than I know what to do with. I don't know how small it's gonna be. Is this sealed? Oh my god, it is. Okay. iOS 9 is busted, AirPlay on Meerkat, and can't put this up on the big screen. Oh, you've been doing it that way. That's a nice. I've done that a couple evenings. It sucks that it did that. I hope they update the Meerkat and it fixes that. It's been a little while since there's been a Meerkat update. I'm seeing what I'm not looking at Periscope. Not that I shouldn't, but I'm seeing the features and the new updates of that, and I'm thinking, wow, I hope that comes to Meerkat. Okay, dang it. Come on. Open up. You can do it. Come on. There you go. Small piece. Well, I'm going with the skinniest piece. Gonna send you a DM too if you do not answer if you are using a syringe. Jurgen, gonna send you a DM too if you do not answer if you are using a ceramic pan and would recommend it. If you were using a ceramic pan and would recommend it. These, those are I believe they're ceramic nonstick. Would I recommend it? Yes. I mean, I like it. It's not good for the camera. It has its flaws, but it works for, you know, an amateur as such as myself. So I hope that kind of answers your question, and I'll answer your email, your DM also. Okay, 1 teaspoon of ground chili. It said chili, and it was kind of vague on that, to be honest. So I'm assuming it means, you know, I can get by with the crushed red pepper right here. So that is going to be 1 teaspoon of that. And I don't know if this counts as whole or not. Well, it's obviously not whole, but it's not ground. There's a reason I'm asking. I'm needing that differentiation. Because the next one is ground. And it's we're going to be roasting these spices. They said roast the whole spices. There's one that's not whole. I don't know if you count that. So I think I'm going to put the nutmeg separately. Nutmeg. Okay. I think it's harder to get good browning with ceramic versus metal. Yes, I concur. I concur with that. Yes, there's a lot of, you know, chefy things that, you know, don't work with the ceramic. That I kind of wish I had, like, cast iron and stuff. Gonna go snap, chat a bit, talk to you later. Thanks for coming by, Rob. Say hello to Cookie and everyone. And the kids, and Chloe, and the kitties, and Vicky. She's not last. She can be first. Okay, ground nutmeg. 1 teaspoon of that. Doesn't seem to make sense to ground. Thank you. We'll try a pan, such a pan instead of a Teflon. Oh yeah, Teflon, not so good. Teflon was kind of the thing, but that releases chemicals and stuff, and it's and if you know, heat it up without any oil in it, it's like the end of the world. So Teflon, not good. The ceramic is better. Between those two, go with the ceramic. what I want, though, is that cast iron thing. Everyone's like, tell me about it, and I want to give that a shot. It's going to be big. I don't know where I'll store it. Okay, 1 teaspoon ground nutmeg. I'm sorry about my nose. Okay. Since we're grating the ground stuff, I'm not gonna roasting the whole stuff, rather I'm gonna keep that separate. Here it goes. So not you, we're going with God I mean, I had a different nonstick that wasn't Teflon. That's the, if you see it, that's what that is. Okay, so we're going to heat that up, and then we're gonna dry roast these until they are lightly colored. Which usually, from my understanding, is like a minute or so. But I tend to get impatient when it comes to putting the stuff on. So, 6:05. This is the fastest cook. The actual cook is so fast. It's like all the time that's gonna be spent here in the prepping. So, thanks for joining me for that. Wibble wobble. Weebles wobble, but they don't fall down. Okay. Camera. Okay, here we go. Okay. I put out the rubber spatula. here. From what I understand, you can roast them this way, or you can roast them in the oven. Also, in a baking dish. I've done both ways. The first time I did anything, this roasting of spices, was for the recipe from Fiji, for their sweet potato and banana curry salad, potato salad, which was really good. At least one person on here has gone out and made it themselves and reported back how good it was, because it is really good. So you can go to cliffyland.com and find the Fiji recipe under Fiji, and that's really good. But it involves just roasting the spices for just a minute. It said lightly colored here, and I don't know how I'm going to see color on here. So you stand there, watch that. I'm going to be right back. Okay. Are you seeing any color here? I'm trying to get some odor out of this. This is all going to go in the spice grinder with the nutmeg, and then that is going to go in a jar, or a bottle rather, when it's done. Which I just got now. I'm not seeing any color. They promised me color. My eyes are blue. My dress is green. My hair is vivid red. If these colors don't look right to you, you're not on a Sony Technicolor. Getting a little jumpy. It is hot. Ish. Not seeing any color, so I'm giving that a little bit minute. Let me get out the spice grinder meanwhile. I'll put it over where you would see it. Yeah, I'm getting some odor. They're gonna see how we're doing here. God, I hate having to sweep like intensely after every meal. Okay, I'm gonna say that's enough. I guess this is where it's using those volatile oils, eh? Okay, I heard a sound. The sound tells me it's done. Okay. So, move back over here. It's granite countertop, I think I'm okay. You have to move so you can see the action here. Alrighty. So into you, I need my camera again. Okay, I'm putting the nutmeg in here too, just to mix it all up. Okay, and the rest here on Gilligan's Isle. Wow. Okay, camera. We'll make it look like I poured it in from there. When in reality, we're gonna use a funnel, because I don't want to spill all over creation. And that I did go out and buy. I did buy me a funnel. And still it falls. There, ta-da! And into, there you go. Hopefully it's gonna fall through. We'll find out in a second. Obviously the piece of cinnamon won't go in. We'll need our funnel again in a moment. Okay. Oh, that's odoriferous. This is where we need the smell-o-vision again. Okay, so here we go. Hold your ears, hit that mute button. Here goes. Warm. Oh my god. Oh, that smells like a dream. Oh my god. Smells like a little of cinnamon from, like, you know, a cookie with Oh my god, that is so good. You have to do this. You have to make this and put it on whatever. Oh my god, that is so good. Okay, so that's our masale mix. I hope I'm not missing anybody. Okay, so I don't forget it. Mr. Organization here. We're writing down to add it to my world o mixes. Masale. On to you. Okay. Funnel once more. And in you go. See, this is why I wanted to do this recipe, because I saw other dishes that had this this mix, but they were too close to what I did on Sunday, and I said no, but I found this one that's a little different than the curry we made on Sunday, and I'm gonna wind up with a nice spice mix that I can use for other stuff as, you know, the days go by. I'm just gonna stand here and smell this all day. I don't want to miss any of it. It is so good. Okay. Ta-da! Have my warm little jar of masale with my crappy handwriting. I am told I have the handwriting of a serial killer. And it's only getting worse. Okay, I will have to clean you out later. Okay, so now that we have our mix done, we're gonna cut up our fish. Now the fish to use here, here's the thing. The recipe, which one, this one comes from, I believe, the BBC, it makes four, serves four. We have two people. The fish is not cheap. It's asking for red snapper or monkfish. They had no monkfish. We have no monkfish today. They had no monkfish. They had red snapper. But the red snapper they had was, like, you know, a piece about, like, you know, size of a baby. And it, even the smallest piece was well over a pound. And I can't do that. It would have been too expensive. And we wouldn't be able to eat it because there's more travel in store for this guy right here. so we wouldn't be able to have leftovers. So I got yellow snapper, and I got half a pound. So that's what's gonna happen. It's gonna wind up in here. I had them take meerkat. Thank you for the light. I had them take the skin off, which now I'm kind of glad I did ask them to do that. But I got me yellow snapper, locally caught, like right off the beach, right out here. Snapper, yellowtail snapper, which I could get half a pound. They give me a bag of ice too. I feel I should save this in case a hurricane comes, but no. Okay, and yellow snapper fillets. So I hope this works the same. It really shouldn't matter. But I feel that it's all this getting, you know, whole snapper would be a big thing cut into pieces. I could see these are, you know, small as a smaller fish. So cutting into chunks seems odder. Seems more like this should just be cooked, you know, as is. And no, I don't have a fish knife. So we have our de-skinned yellowtail snapper that I'm gonna cut into bite-sized pieces. And I'm gonna get my knife and I'm gonna get a slicing. Yeah, I don't need to take a picture of that. Okay, here goes. Bite size. I'm trying to see if I can do without using the OCD cutting board. Again, now that I've gotten a general idea of size on things, it's about learning. All about the learning. So meerkat person, are you? Or I'm guessing you're probably not with the official meerkat app people. That's just a guess on my part. Correct me if I'm wrong. Good seeing you. Followed you on the Twitter there with the kids and the rock and roll. And their funny pants. So chopping into bite-sized pieces, the yellowtail snapper. The other thing about this is that, like I said, I halved the amount of fish, but I didn't have the amount of anything else, except for the onion, because I thought that would add volume. So I have the two things. And the water, and the stock that gets added at the end. I cut that in half also. So I'm hoping my ratios, you know, I tried to cut the things that added volume and leave the things that added flavor. This is my strategy. I hope it's not off. Because this whole mathematics of cutting down the recipes to serve two instead of serving, you know, 8 to 102 is always half the battle here. If you go back in the blogs, then you'll see that that was my number one concern all the way at the beginning, even. Eventually, I started making like giant pots of food that would serve anyway, and then I'd just be eating it, you know, two meals a day for the next 2 or 3 days. But now I'm cooking like 2 and 3 times a week. That makes it even more complicated. So, this is Seychelles, again, island nation in the Indian Ocean, off the coast of Madagascar, near the nations of Comoros, and off the coast of Kenya. It is the smallest, Lauper, thank you for the like and the restream. Cliff, I know I'm just another streamer, too late to change my name. Does confuse some people. Yeah, I dig it. That's kind of what I figured. Not a problem. Okay, we've chopped this up. Let me cover this up, and then we'll put that in the fridge, and then we'll keep going. You know what? I think I have another lily pad that may serve be just that size. Because there's a whole set in here, but usually I don't get to use the smaller ones. Oh, looky, looky, looky. There was a smaller one. Yay! Save on the plastic wrap. That's for shizzle. Okay. Into the fridge. Into the fridge, if there's room anywhere in the damn fridge. Anywhere, somewhere. Wow. Okay. I think we're okay. Nothing's gonna fall. I'm gonna clean this off, be right back. Anyway, about the Seychelles. Island nation, technically, they're the nation in Africa, the African nation, with the smallest population. That is, they count as an African nation even though they're off the coast. And it's the smallest population of an African nation that's an independent nation, as opposed to a protectorate or part of another country. Because there are some islands that have smaller populations that would be that. They have less than 100,000 people. And they've been independent since 1976. They were unpopulated. There was no native population. Some people had kind of, you know, perhaps discovered it before. But Europeans landed in like 1512, and the French decided, okay, it's ours. And then in the Napoleonic Wars, they had to hand it over to the British under the condition that the French people got to stay and not, you know, lose their property and get killed and stuff. And so the French had brought in African slaves. They banned, they abolished slavery. And then the British started bringing in Indian indentured servants to work vanilla fields and other, you know, plantations. You get a lot of vanilla from there, incidentally. So that's why the people are a Creole mix of British and French and African and Indian and Chinese. And the food is a mix of all those things too. And you're kind of seeing that in like our little masala curry spice and such. So, little tip right there. And also their ocean fish. They're one of the countries that I've seen all the fish is like fresh fish in the recipes. Whereas I keep discovering all these in other island nations where everything is like salted fish, which is not my favorite. Although I've made it okay. So I'm gonna start setting out stuff for the rest. Again, it's a very, very fast cook. So again, we're going with sunflower oil. So I'm just gonna do the prep so I can put it all together at the end rather quickly. Hey Babs, I see you there. One Mississippi. To Mississippi. So we're going sunflower oil this time. It's story time with Cliffy, yes. I do try. Sunflower oil, again. Kind of bugged me that I can only get one brand there. Okay, but both these recipes call for sunflower oil, so that's what we're using. Okay, onions, yes. Onion time means Cliffy Del. Story time. Now, I wasn't sure if I should, I cut this in half. The amount of onion in half. Because I didn't want to add to the volume. So what do you think? Should I have two onions or should I have one onion? I have a pound of fish instead of 2 pounds of fish. So should I have one onion instead of two onions, or should I like have everything else the same and just have less fish and less liquid? I'm thinking less onion. That's my thought process. So tell me if I'm wrong. The Seychelles, they became independent in 1976. They had a president, and there was a coup about a year or two right after independence, because it was kind of the hot spot to be seen, beaches and resorts and stuff. And from what I gather, the way that was working out didn't go over too well. So the guy was deposed, and the guy who came in ruled until single party kind of dictatorship thing until 93, I believe. And then he had, you know, opened it up, even though he remained the president, until like 03 when he handed it over to his son. Well, his son ran, his son won, and has continued to win. So the deal there is lots and lots of tourism. They get more than 30% of their economy from tourism. Lots of, if you Google pictures of Seychelles, you'll get lots of beautiful beach pictures, infinity pools and waves and beautiful people and all that good stuff. They were hit by a big cyclone a few years back, kind of hurt them rather badly. I think they were affected by the big tidal wave back in whatever, '07 was it? I don't remember the year. The Christmas one. But they didn't say much about that. I think that's where Star Jones had said she'd had. She said, "Oh my God, I could have been killed. I was just there 3 weeks ago on my honeymoon." It's like, no, it doesn't work that way. Okay. But yes, there's lots of vacation spots there. They are trying to get more sort of ecotourism, where people go and, you know, look at and help protect the environment, because there's some animals and plants that are only found there and nowhere else in the whole wide world. So it's pretty cool to go see them. They're trying to get more of like people coming to the country to stay rather than like short-term cruise people. Babs, hey, thank you. Tsunami 2004, yes. Yes, that was, I just remember that was the year that Lost started. And their whole timeline, I remember on Lost, was if they're there, do they make it, do they last through Christmas? Do they see the tsunami? That was a discussion among Lost fans, as I recall. So, chopping onions. So it said two onions, I'm going with one. It said roughly 4 cups of stock, and I'm going with two. It said roughly 2 pounds of fish. I went with one. Everything else I'm keeping the same. And wouldn't you know, for the first time in forever, my eyes are reacting to the chopping onions. Usually that does not happen. Today, it does. I do not know why that is. Okay. Moving on. Okay, we've got half an onion. Going for the other half. Here we go. Yeah, so, if you didn't see on Sunday, when I was cooking Seychelles, night one, God, my eyes. I just come back from traveling, which is why we only had 2 nights instead of 3 this week. Went to LA and had an amazing time. And, I saw Usher and, Claire Danes, which was kind of crazy. So, and I almost saw Tim Tebow, but I don't care about him. But I guess if you're in LA, like, seeing celebrities is like, you know, big deal. You go out to the grocery store, oh, there's one. Here, not so much. Funny thing is, we lived in Columbus. Babs. We lived in Columbus for Ohio for a number of years. And one of the famous people from Columbus, Ohio is Jack Hanna, head of the Columbus Zoo. You usually see him on every like nighttime talk show kind of thing, bringing animals and such. I did some work for the zoo, and so I almost got a chance to meet him, but I said, what would I say? Like, hi, nice to meet you. Now I'm going to go back to fixing your computers. And the husband got to interview him for about his book. And so we moved to here, to Jupiter, Florida. And the very first day, we decided to go out to have breakfast at the little place around the corner. And who do we see there but Jack Hanna? Apparently he spends most of his time here. Irony? Chopped onions. Okay, so... So garlic. We're going next to the garlic. Coño. I better be clear of this schmutz in my nose, like, really soon. I feel like 99%. If I could run 10 miles this morning, I think I'm okay. I tried doing 10 miles in LA. I should have gotten up earlier. I was doing really well, too. Because we were staying in Beverly Hills, of all places. And I don't know if you're familiar with LA, but I was just awestruck. So I jogged out, and I went up Rodeo Drive, and it was in the morning, and it was cool, and it was dry, and not here, like here. And I jogged all the way up Sunset, Santa Monica Boulevard, and then went all the way up to the Sunset Strip, which is like straight uphill. And by the time I got up there, I was like, oh, I'm gonna die. And then to come back, I came down this long vertical street, which was not very exciting. But that's when it got like insanely hot and the sun was burning and it felt like 100 degrees and I thought I was gonna die. I was so embarrassed I had to walk the last mile. I don't normally do that. So, notice I'm not using my gizmo. Yeah, I think you're right, it's faster to peel the garlic this way. Especially if you're gonna dice it. By the way, Babs, thanks for the restream if I did not mention that before. Okay, 2 cloves of garlic. Let me get a thing for this. Okie doke. Lose the end. Go away. Thank you for the restream, Meerkat. And so we're gonna fry the onions and garlic, obviously. It's like, seems to be the first step of every recipe in the world. Another weird thing about Seychelles, and it was kind of hard to verify this. Now remember, they have a very, very small population. But allegedly, in 2012, they passed the United States for the highest percentage of their population, which was incarcerated. Not really a statistic you wanna have. Not one we wanna have either, but when I looked at the chart, I couldn't see it that way. So either it's just not that way now, it was that way then, or somebody lied. But that was a weird little statistic. Okay, so. By the way, things and people from the Seychelles are Seychellois. So a hint of the French right there. And the language is, English Creole. It's like a mix of English and French and various other languages. But the official language is English. Garlic. Okay. So now we're going to set aside other stuff. So am I done with the chopping? I'm done with the chopping, yay! So we're gonna clean this off. I've become a big fan of this thing called the tasting table. It doesn't have anything to do with tonight's recipe, but it has got like the best information. Honest to God, every time they come up my feed. It's something else. It's either a really great recipe or really great cooking tips. You know, we talked about brown sugar before, and I used a little clay bear in there to keep it soft. Turned out, apparently, you can also put a piece of apple or a piece of bread in with your brown sugar, and amazingly, it doesn't get moldy, and it keeps the brown sugar from getting all hard. And though it makes the bread and the apple inedible, they don't get moldy. And apparently it's best to keep your brown sugar in a separate airtight container rather than the original plastic bag, but I did not do that. Oh, nuts, I still have one more thing to chop. Bad me. I need to chop a small piece of ginger. That's gonna go in there. And then how small. I don't wanna do too much. And they say that it's best to peel this with a spoon. How small? God, I hate it when they just give you vague instructions like that. Two people, no? Maybe a little more. Small is a relative term. Yeah, I'm gonna hope that's enough. Hope. How do you define small? Okay. I'm gonna try the spoon. See if that works. This is my garbage. Allegedly, this works. Well, at least I don't cut my hands as much. See, also, now that I put the stuff on YouTube, Carrie Osborne, thank you for the like and the restream. Since I put this on YouTube, when I was cooking Serbia, one of the nights of Serbia, apparently for a certain period of time, I did not speak. And the time was long enough for the YouTube to go, "You're violating somebody's copyright with the music." And I had to go put a challenge in, which is annoying. So if the cat's wondering, that's why I keep talking to myself. Katie. Soon, the second he hears the clang of the pots, he goes, "Okay, that's it for me today." That. Come on. I think this is too small. But I'm going to get to jog in a different city soon. So I've jogged in D.C. and New York, and now Los Angeles, and of course Florida here. But I signed up for my second half marathon. I did one back in 2012, and I was sure that I wasn't gonna be able to finish. And I did walk part of it, but I did it. This time I'm like, 13 miles, I could do that. That seems too small. That does seem too small. I need more. I think I need more. Too small. You know, considering every last thing they were saying, I need this many milligrams of whatever. Seems odd. Seems odd that they would just be so vague in that case. I want to bite. Okay. Peeling garlic. See, again, I started really early today, even though the cook is 10 minutes long, because I know that it's going to be a problem, because I talk so much, and I'm so slow with my prep. I mean, it's like the dinners keep getting later and later and later, and the husband's a dear to put up with it, but he shouldn't have to. So we finished watching Narcos, by the way. Great show. Highly recommended on Netflix. Narcos. If you don't mind violence. But true stories. And I lived in the 80s in Miami, so I saw the other end of that. They said in the 80s that, one out of every two $20 bills had traces of cocaine on it. And I believe it. I was there. I have stories. There's some stories that probably wouldn't go well here. It involved criminality and other people. Not me. Okay. Excuse me, I'm gonna be right back. Okay, sorry about that. And we're back. Okay, so we're chopping up garlic here. Not garlic, ginger. So that. Oh, very quiet now. You're probably having dinner yourself. I was saying, my mother, when I scheduled the stream yesterday, I got a text from her saying, "Why can't I see you? Why can't I see you? I'm looking at the app, I can't see you." And I was thinking, well, if I was actually cooking, I wouldn't be able to see her text. But then I just said, "No, Mom, I just scheduled the stream. That's the notification that I scheduled the stream for tomorrow." But then she said, "Oh, I've been watching all these other people. There's a nice lady who was talking about something. But I put the phone down and I just walk away." And I'm thinking, that's everyone. I believe I'm talking to the dog. People's dogs half the time. Okay. So that is the ginger. And now we're going to set up that spice mix that we just made. Which is two tablespoons of the mix. So we made our masala mix. We're setting out 2 tablespoons of it. Okay. Here we go. One. Two. I wish you could smell this. That is heaven. That is absolute heaven. That is so tasty. Might miss something. But might miss something. You might? I'm not, what, putting stuff down? Back to referring to what I was making? I'm here, I mean. Oh, well, thank you. I'm glad you're here. I very much appreciate your being here. We're going with 1/2 teaspoon of ground turmeric, which is spelled with an R. Which I keep forgetting. Spell check always comes to my rescue on that one. I should learn to spell it. It's spelled turmeric with 2 R's. Turmeric. And it makes everything orange and yellow, including all my napkins and the counter and everything. And you can always find it afterwards when you clean. Everything is still yellow and orange. 1/2 teaspoon. 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric. By the way, the music changed now. Oh my god, I can't pronounce it. Rondarian Mansa Harrison Rowland doing Rasingara, in case you're wondering. Turmeric. Okay. And here's an interesting thingy. It said tamarind water. And the deal is... Let me find my tamarind, hold on. said tamarind water. Now I have tamarind paste. One R.
Yes.
T-U-R-M-U-R-I-C. Turmeric. Tamarind. Tamarind paste. It says to use tamarind water. I looked it up, and it seems that, you would make tamarind water with actual tamarinds and water, but we're using tamarind paste, and so apparently it's a 3-to-1 ratio, tablespoons. So let me get some water over here. So I'm gonna put in a little over 2 tablespoons of water. 1, 2. Okay. And a little over 1 tablespoon of the tamarind paste, because it's concentrated. So, gonna mix that up. Yeah, when I cooked the curry on Sunday, it said to put lime juice to finish it at the end, and I made the executive decision to not use lime juice and use the tamarind paste instead. And thankfully, I had the good sense there to not use equal amounts, because it is very strong. It is like the definition of tart. I mean, that's... it's tart. That is like the definition of tart. It's a little sour, but tart is really the word. And kind of sweet, and I really love it. I'm used to having it on the Puerto Rican shaved ice. Called piragua. Piragua. If anybody saw the play In the Heights, there's a piraguero. Sing a piragua. I miss me piraguas. Okay, so we've got our tamarind water that we have made, so we're putting that aside. Now we're gonna put out the leaves from 2 sprigs of thyme. Boom. Okay, we've got our thyme. Well, that's 2 sprigs right there. This time is not gonna... It's gonna go bad by the time I get to it. I just know it. Oh my god, I need more water. It is 6:49. It's a 10-minute cook, people. I need to reheat the rice from Sunday also. And I'm, like I said, I'm a little worried, because when I've reheated rice before, it's either been too dry or too mushy. So I need to find the right amount of water to add to it, to keep it from being so... And I need to know when to put it in. I think I put it on as soon as I'm finished with this prep right here. Come on. Heck. By the way, I was in LA. I had Korean barbecue, which is unbelievable. But also, I had a parsley salad with stems and all. And it was not a tabbouleh, but it was really, really tasty. So thyme. We got our thyme right there. And anise. 1/2 teaspoon of anise. See, here's the thing. When you do Asian cooking, and this is, you know, very related to Indian cooking. You'll get like a million spices and stuff, which the flavor is my favorite. The time it takes is not. But the payoff is really good. So 1/2 teaspoon. of anise. 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 It smells like licorice. You can freeze thyme for later use. Oh, thank you. Freeze thyme for later use. After... Huh. All these things are in the freezer. I'm gonna have to label stuff. I'm gonna have to remember to do that. Not right now, though. A half a teaspoon of anise. 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 Okay, right there. It smells like licorice. Which I don't like licorice, but in combination with other stuff. Good. Okay. And this seems kind of goofy. But... getting a cup of the seafood stock, and I'm gonna put it out now. Oh, you know, I'm just gonna put the thyme in the freezer, but I'm gonna have to remember the thyme is in the freezer. Now I need to organize the freezer before I do that. It's just gonna get lost in there. So we've got our seafood stock. Now here's the other part. I'm going with half, with one cup instead of two. Since I went with half the volume on the fish and half the volume on the onion, but everything else is full for the, so even though I have the recipe, I'm only having the water, the fish, and the onion, and I'm hoping that's the right combination. I do not know if it is. My collection of stocks in there. Okay. I think I'm there. Yes, I am there. I am there, and it is, sheesh, it's not even 7 yet. That's a problem. Why isn't he home, by the way? It's probably the gym. Okay. Okay, let me heat up the rice. I can always do dishes while I wait, right? Okay. Get a lid for that. Ta-da. You know, I have a friend who gave us, as a wedding present, big, like, not chafing dish. I think you'd roast a whole, like, turkey and stuff in. It's, like, that big. I wish I had an opportunity to use it. And it costs a pile of money, I'm sure. Let me put all this over here. Okay, we're gonna reheat our rice from Sunday. I hope there's enough in there. This is our Creole rice from Sunday. I know there's gonna need to be some water added to that, I think. I'm assuming. So, I hope I don't drop it all over the counter. Here we go. Oh, very sticks together. Oh my god, I actually wound up with actual pegao. Pegao is the Puerto Rican that the rice that burns to the bottom of the pot is tasty and crunchy, and you eat it like as a thing, and you want some in your dish. So for the first time, actually, you know, and the Persians for the Iranian dish, the whole thing that sticks to the bottom is quite a very specific thing, and the guest of honor gets it. I kind of wind up with that. How much water to add? I'm just gonna add like a very little. I hope that's right. And I'm gonna have that on a very low heat. It's gonna have to be there for a long time. Sheesh. It's not home yet. It's only gonna take like 10 minutes to cook. Okay, so what's gonna happen here is that the guy, I'm gonna get the skillet, the big old skillet. So while you watch there, we're gonna move over to this empty spot. And this one, the one with the white balance problems. See, you can't see? Maybe give you a better view. Okay, so it's gonna be sunflower oil, onions, the mix, the turmeric, the fish, and then 10 minutes and boom, it's done. So I should not start that now. Because at most that's 15 minutes total. Even with me taking pictures and babbling. I can't see that going longer. So you're gonna get to watch me clean. Feel free to ask any questions if you'd like. This week you don't need to look at the dishes. You can look at me washing the dishes, which is even more exciting. By the way, Tupperware. See, because actual Tupperware goes flat, and you can put it in the dishwasher. Nuts. I should have, I mentioned at the very beginning of this that I should have emptied the dishwasher. Now I really should have emptied the dishwasher. So again, ask any questions you feel like, because we're half killing time here. While I wait for the husband to get home, I'm cleaning. But this is Seychelles. This is night 2 of 2 for Seychelles. We're gonna be cooking, next week, 2 nights also, but they're not going to be the same nights. It's going to be Sunday? Yeah, Sunday and Tuesday. Or, wait a minute. No, not. It's going to be maybe Thursday and Tuesday. But next week is Sierra Leone. We're heading back to Africa. I will have exhausted every African dish known to mankind. With the 57 African nations, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. Ah! Got dark all of a sudden. It's quite the challenge to find things I'm not repeating the same recipes over and over again. And, because I've done just about every other country in West Africa so far. This is off the coast of East Africa, so thankfully it's more Indian, which is kind of a relief, but there'll only be Sierra Leone, I think there'll be Togo, that might be it for West Africa, so we'll be coming to the end of those. Bye! Thanks for coming by! We'll be serving in about 45 minutes, should anyone feel like leaving, coming back. Not coming home yet. So, that's what's happening. Sorry for hitting the very boring portion of the evening. Feel free to ask anything you'd like while we wait, because it's 10 minutes to cook and I don't want it to overcook. And if he was here already, I would be cooking it now. But he'd be freaking out that I hadn't emptied the dishwasher. So that's why I'm doing that now. So, to keep family harmony. So, where are you all? Anyway, I know where some of you are, but I don't know where some of you are. No, my good friend Neil's here in Belgium. Actually looks at the streams after the fact, which is very nice of him. Shout out to Neil's, my Apple Watch Snapchat buddy. Get close. Okay. At least he won't be mad. When did you get married? We got married in 2012. No, in 2013, sorry. And we got married in D.C. Ontario, Canada. Hey, oh, wow. That's, Ontario's a big place. Like Toronto or environs or somewhere else. I very much love Canada. But we got married in 2013 in D.C. because that's where we met. We've been together for 24, going on 25 years now. So we're old. Old married couple. I wanted to attempt to share something potentially unpleasant. I don't want to bring up a bad memory. When we were in Key West a couple weeks ago, some random person said something really obnoxious, but, you know, it was like a jigsaw puzzle. I heard half of it, and the husband heard half of it, and we didn't put it together until I'd walked away. And if I had put it together at the time, I would have let them have it with both barrels. Thank you. Thank you, Martina. Thank you very much. Yes, we did not wait till it became legal in Florida, because since Florida doesn't have a state income tax, there was no real downside. Whereas friends in Ohio had just south of Toronto. Nice. Toronto has quite the traffic. I like Toronto. Oh my God, I have a story. I have a story about everything. But you know, since we're killing time, it's, you know, it's story time. So, once upon a time, long, long time ago, I was with my parents and uncle and aunt and cousins, and we went to Toronto as we were, you know, going through. And this is before the internet and cell phones and maps and stuff. And we got to make sure he isn't here. We were driving through, and my dad was lost trying to find the hotel. And we were pulling over, and I was about, I mean, I knew which way was up on my end. I was, you know, a teenager, let's put it that way. And we're driving, and my cousin's about my age, too. So we were both about, like, 16. And he pulls over to get directions, and I'm looking around the neighborhood, and I'm thinking, does this seem like a gay neighborhood? This seems like a gay neighborhood. But, you know, my dad wasn't going to pick up on that. So he went in to use the phone, and, oh, and my cousin said something obnoxious about it. Oh, it looks like a lot of them, you know, around here. And he goes in to use the phone, and he goes into this bar, and he goes to use the payphone, and it's dimly lit, and it's dark, and it's really early. It's still daylight out. And he's using the phone, his back is to the room, he's looking at the phone, and, like, all these guys in leather are all kind of, like, walking in behind him into the bar, and I'm like, oh, shit, no, he can't see this. Let's get him out of here right now. So, that was my experience in Toronto. Brief as it was. So, back to cleaning. He's not home yet. If he gets home in the next, you know, 5 minutes, we'll start cooking. Because 15 minutes is all it takes to cook what we're gonna cook. And I started at 5, because like I said, everything has been so late lately. And I've been really bad about that. No, it's strange, because I hadn't, think about that Key West thing. There's a place I worked once in my training. We got this sort of philosophical training, sort of, called Assume Positive Intent, which was kind of life-changing, because I didn't normally go through my life that way. But it was assuming, like, even if, you know, somebody comes in with something really, you know, horrible or says something really horrible, assume that they mean something nice before you assume they mean something bad. Which is a good philosophical way to look at things. Because I'm kind of hair triggered otherwise. So like last week there was her husband probably thinks he has all kinds of time to get home, lol. Yeah, that too. That too. I mean, dinner's been so late the last few times. So, but I told him it was a really fast cook. So, I don't know. But he had to stop and get cat food too. It's weird, the cat only likes Trader Joe's cat food. Our cat is a yuppie. We have a yuppie cat. Thankfully, it's like the least expensive cat food too. So he has to make the special trip for the cat. So the cat gets very scared when he hears any sounds in the kitchen. But anyway, the assume positive intent is, you know, nice because, like there was a person on here a couple weeks ago who, you know, said something, and my first instinct was to be like, you know, get mad. And it's a good thing I didn't. So it wound up well. Assume positive intent. Philosophy. Philosophy while cleaning. There's no no Tai Chi happening here, but we do get to clean a bowl. Okie dokie. And amazingly, so we wound up with and yet more garbage. It's supposed to be a papaya, it's supposed to be octopus salad, wound up being a green papaya salad, supposed to be green papaya salad, wound up being an avocado salad. It's supposed to be originally from Seychelles, now it's a Clippyland creation. And based on the original novel, green papaya salad, pushed by Sapphire. I don't know if anybody got that, but I enjoyed it. I like to make myself laugh. Some of these jokes are just for me, people. Okay. Wow. Okay. We are clean. You know, I'm gonna ask the magic iPad. You know what? I'm gonna ask the magic iPad. Maybe the magic iPad has an answer for me. Shall we? Where is my husband?
Looking for Doug Whiteman. Checking the whereabouts of Doug Whiteman.
Come on. Get back here. No bueno. You need to get back here faster. He's a Trader Joe's. Hey Jonesy, thank you for the follow. Less to do after supper. That's true, that's true. You know what? Since I'm sitting here, the thing I do, since, you know, I'm officially killing time. Oh my god, how many people posted this stupid hoax on Facebook? I don't think that could happen. Drives me out of my mind. In any case, let's see. I do a status update when I cook, but I usually forget when I'm busy streaming. But now, I'm sitting here, standing here waiting. So, let's see. Let's see, comma, we're, apostrophe, by the seashore. Comma, we're not selling anything. Thing, but tonight it's Seychelles. I was trying to find up like something funny, humorous, punny. I could only work off the she sells seashells by the seashore. Oh, that's not right. No. My fat fingers. IT apostrophe S. Okay, and always exclamation point for excitement. Post. Okay, there we go. So, I say we just start. Yeah, we're just gonna start. Here we go, people. Wake up. This is not a drill. We are actually starting to cook. Woohoo! People have been insanely patient. Oh my god, you people are troopers. Super troopers. I'm gonna put everything by here because I got sunflower oil first. Heat you up. And onions go next. 1 cup. It's gonna fit in there, right? Yeah. Okay. Onions, the masala mix, which is gonna go next. I swear, this is the best smelling thing in the world. Just bury me with this. Oh my god. Okay, turmeric. And iPad. Camera, okay, I got my spatula. Let's see how, so is my rice doing okay over here? Somebody something. Love your show. You are very nice. Claudia Marie, you're lovely. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Okay, so still not hot enough. So it's gonna be the onions, the masala mix, the turmeric, we're gonna fry it, then I'm gonna add the fish. So might as well get that. You people are very sweet. That's your salad. I just love these. I do. Magic. Then all the ingredients. Then everything else goes in. Like, everything. So I gotta make room, because it's gonna be a parade of ingredients. That is the garlic. The thyme, the ginger, the cumin, and the tamarind water. So that is our, thank you for the like, Claudia Marie. Gotta make sure I follow people in case I'm not already. Okay, thank you. Oh, I am, good. Oh, you know what would be good if you could actually see what's going on? That would be handy, wouldn't it? Cooking show, you can actually see what's cooking. Okay, this feels warm enough now. So here is picture number 1,000,003 of onions going into oil. Little sizzle there. And onions and the masala mix, right? Until golden. Okay. You gotta wait. How are you, my good friend? Who are we talking to? Austin, hello there. I'm on a weird angle, so it's hard to see. I am doing okay. It's been an interesting day. I jogged my 10 miles. I kind of passed out afterwards. The idea here was to be two dishes. What's cooking? Looks delicious. Two dishes. One is done. Dish one was to be originally an octopus salad. I got all my ingredients for my octopus salad except for my octopus. I was realizing how if I want to use whole, you know, full-size octopus, you can only buy it frozen, and it takes, to have it cooked properly, you want to defrost it over 24 hours. Ergo, whole octopus off the table. Plan B, baby octopus. Only have to boil that for a few minutes if it's fresh and not frozen. I went to the store, the fishmonger. I got my fish. As for the octopus, they always have baby octopus. Dude comes back with octopus salad with teriyaki. Not what I needed. I said, thank you very much. I went outside. I called about four places. Either they didn't have it or they only had it frozen, which again leads me back to the defrosting issue. So I decided, okay, octopus salad, not happening. This is all just a few hours ago. So octopus salad off the table. Went looking for a replacement salad. The replacement salad for Seychelles was to be the green papaya salad, which is very much like green papaya from Laos and such, Myanmar, that area. Went to the market, produce market, with a very unfriendly lady working there who's not having a good day. I ask her if she has green papaya. She says, just go that way. I go there, I find regular ripe papaya, and I find what appears to be green papaya on top with a big sign that says papaya, ergo green papaya. I come back here, I start the stream, I have all my ingredients ready for my green papaya salad. And I am babbling about the joys of green papaya as I peel what turns out to be a Florida avocado. Not a green papaya. Cue embarrassment and shame. As live, I figured out what to do. I decided that frying said avocado would not be a great idea. So I made what would have been the green papaya salad, the, you know, two, three ingredients, and mixed it in with the avocado. And rather than serve it warm off the stove, it's going to be cold out of the fridge. A avocado salad a la Cliffy Mistake. Dish two, this right here, is a Seychelles fish curry. We prepared our glorious spice mix, which is the key to all this, the masala spice mix, which is the greatest smell in the known universe. That, it is like cinnamon with cumin and coriander and peppercorns, and it is superb. Superb. So, that is going to go in next with the turmeric, and then we got fish. Problem two was this dish was that it serves four. I'm only cooking for two. And while I normally do the whole thing and have leftovers, traveling, as we have been this past week and we will be this week, is making the leftover issue complicated. Wendy, is that Wendy? Wendy Jean, thank you for the like and the restream. I cut it in half, but rather than, I learned the hard way that if I cut, everything in half, like straight down the middle, I wind up with crappy food because I cut half the flavor. So I made the executive decision, which I hope will not bite me in the patootie, to just use 1 pound of fish, a cold for red snapper or monkfish. The red snapper was, they're all very expensive, but the red snapper was a piece that was like about over, well over a pound. Which was more than we could eat. And so I nixed the red snapper, went with the yellow snapper, locally caught, fresh, you know, right off the fishing line, right out here. I could walk to where they fish here. And so I got half of that. I'm using half of the onion. Instead of two onions, I'm using one. And thank you, John M. Blake, for the like and the restream. So I cut the onions in half, because I figured that would add to the volume, the onions would. I also cut the liquid in half. But the rest I left whole, because I'm hoping I get whole flavor instead of half the flavor. That is my strategy. So right now I am stirring these until golden, which I'm guessing they want them to caramelize. And one thing I've learned in this process is that onions take a hell of a long time to caramelize. They just do. There's apparently even a controversy that I read about with people saying, you know, these recipes say caramelize, it'll take, you know, 5-10 minutes. And then other people saying, no, it takes 20 minutes to half an hour to truly caramelize onions. And I'm thinking, that is a hell of a long time to sit there and stare at an onion. But, they're gonna give it the college try here. Besides, we're kind of killing time till the husband gets home. Because he is buying cat food for a fussy, fussy cat who only likes Trader Joe's. Other stuff's like, no, where's the good stuff? Which is good, this about the cheapest cat food you can find. Ack, 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 ack. Burning onion, onion burning on my fingers. Ow. Owie, ow. Go away. Oh god, if that gets on the counter, shoo. This burns to the countertop and you can't get it off. Ow, 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 ow. As I mentioned before I started this whole project, I didn't know how to cook anything at all. And I would routinely start fires, accidentally, by leaving stuff, then just walking away and watching Guiding Light or something. You're starting to burn a little, turning it down. Do not want burnt, I want caramelized. Trying to sweat them out. That burnt my finger. No, once I started so many fires accidentally when I was in college, I can't even count them. Felt like I had to disable the smoke detector. Cause it was bad. You know, one time I had a candle, someone gave me a candle for Christmas, and the wick, you know, it's a big candle, the wick had gone into the candle. And I was like, no, I want to burn out the rest of this candle. And so I put in like a matchstick, thinking I would make like another wick. And then it started to melt faster, and then faster, taking off the heat, cools the hot pan. Taking off the heat, cools the hot pan faster. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, Hector. Yes, I don't want to burn, I do want to caramelize. Hector, you are a lifesaver, you. You guys rock. Well, I say that's that's caramelized dish. A little burnt. But anyway, I put in the wick in the candle, and it was like going down, it's coming down faster, and it was melting faster, and I like kept adding matches as it was burning out, and then I put the matchbook cover and I lit that, and it was all melting very fast, and I put paper towels to catch all the wax that was falling onto the countertop, and then the paper towels caught fire, and then that was not a pretty sight. Okay. Time's up. So we're gonna add our turmeric and our masala. Now the house smells like all sorts of gloriousness. And then we're adding the turmeric. You get it all nice and orange. Orange, sporange, nothing rhymes with orange. Ooh.
Oh, wow. Now it's all Indian smelling. And we're frying this for just lightly. Mix it all up. And then we're going to add our fish. Oh, the smell. I bet the neighbors can smell that. So we're going to add in our fish, which we had our yellow snapper, yellowtail snapper. Clunk. And then add everything else. Turning it down. Thank you for the tip on the lifting. So here goes with the garlic. I can get out of the damn bowl. The thyme. The cumin. No, is that cumin? Yeah. I've lost my mind. Ginger. The tamarind water. Right hand, left hand. Okay. The temperature way down, in case you're wondering. Six. Okay. And the fish stock. And we cook that for 10 minutes. And you damn well better be home by then. Not so loud now, is it? So that tamarind stuff tastes so good. Ow. You know what I did notice? There's peppercorns in there, but did not say anything about salt. Did not say a thing about that. No, it did not. It did not, it did not. I'm thinking that's important. I'm thinking salt is going to be important. It did not say a thing about salt. I will taste it. After 10 minutes, I will taste it. So I'm going to let it sit there. Meanwhile, I'm reheating my rice from Sunday over here. I'm hoping this is okay. I put a little bit of water in it, so it would not be horrible. Because previously I added more water, and I think I put... You've got to season with salt. Thank you. Thank you for the tip. Sometimes I just need to know the obvious, you know? It's like recipes kind of assume, you know, the obvious, and you should never assume with me. And still still tasty, still spicy. These are leftovers of the Creole rice from Sunday, if you missed it. This basmati rice with red bell peppers and hot chili pepper. Which is making it quite hot. And lots of turmeric and other seasonings also. That's very good. But yes, I need to season that with salt. So it's going to be this, with this on the side, and the avocado salad. And the husband's preference is always to have one dish, if at all possible, rather than separate dishes, just for awkwardness sake. But we're going to get our plates out now. and see what happens, eh? Seychelles, I'll go swimming. So, poll question. It's not like an official meerkat poll, but poll. So, how far from where you are, how long would you have to drive to get to a beach? Totally random question. The beach can be a big lake, I guess. Like if you're like Lake Michigan or something. So I'm washing while I quiz you. I'm curious about people. We have several Canadians in the house, in his house. We've had, we know at least two from Vancouver and one from Ontario. And if Canada's still here, we know he's in Wyoming. 10 minutes. Wow. That's handy. That is very nice. That is very nice. So that would be Lake Ontario. I mean, summers get hot in Toronto. I know that. I know it can get humid there. Growing up in Florida, I always thought, oh, up north, if, you know, like if I figured if I drove an hour north, it would be cooler. I just said anywhere north of here would be cooler. Unless it's an ocean, then it's 3 days driving. 3 days? I find that hard to believe, 3 days. Taking lots of pit stops. Yeah, so wow. I've seen a beach on Rob. Rob says 30 minutes. Hey, Ben. Rob says 30 minutes. I'm 10 minutes from Lake Ontario and about an hour from Lake Erie. Okay, cool. Cool, cool, cool. Rob says 30 minutes. See, isn't it, because I lived in Columbus for a while, and it broke my heart. Hey, Ben, long time no see. How you been? Haven't been seeing your streams. I've been like traveling and very busy and ill and traveling some more. But no, we're talking about how, from where you are, how far would it be for you? How long would you have to drive to get to a beach? Because when I lived in Ohio, I mean, I was just thinking like, somewhere there's a water, somewhere I have to see water. I never thought I would be so longing for water, for an ocean. And I'm not a beach guy, but I just dreamt of it. And I thought, oh, I drove all the way to Michigan, to Saugatuck. Like, what, Michigan is this? So here's, you know, here, the Saugatuck is on this side. And there was a lake. It was acceptable. I drove to Cleveland, but that, you know, it's Cleveland. Cleveland has its charms. Jonesy, thank you for the restream. Cleveland has its charms. But, you know, there's also some truth to it being kind of depressing. But I've been to Cleveland many times. Rock and Roll Hall of Fame multiple times. It's like one of my favorite places. So, God, no, but when I moved here, like, we're on the beach. I mean, like, I jog, you know, 8 minutes, and I'm at the beach. If I drove, it would be like, you know, I'd have to go around. It'd be like 2 minutes. Ray, thank you for the restream. A good, good sir. Raymond, yes, Raymond, hey. You follow on Facebook. Thank you very much. Not that many, oddly enough, Facebook is so popular, but not that many people like and follow the blog on Facebook as they do on other social media, which I find curious. Just curious. Okay, let's see what's cooking. So we have, she's gonna be so impressed that I clean so much. We have our fish, which has been sitting here for almost 10 minutes. and our rice, which is being reheated from Sunday over yonder. Oh, I know I should chop fresh parsley for this. You don't have to remind me. But I chopped so much before that I have leftover chopped parsley. I'm not gonna quibble on that. I will quibble the fact that it's cold, but that's for dressing the rice. Then not say anything about dressing the fish. But salt was mentioned, which would be important. You know, maybe it is time to taste. Tasting time. You stay. Here goes. That's too low. Wow. Wow. Very strong. Very strong. Very gingery. Yeah, you're right, it needs salt. You are so right. I put parsley on everything. It's so versatile. I keep plugging this tasting table thing. I get no benefit from them. But, they're so good. They had a thing said, what to do with your leftover parsley last week. And, to make a tabbouleh, that one I knew, and I had actually just done that. But it said to make a broth, and all these other things you can make with it. Did you go to the Seychelles? No, I did not go to the Seychelles. I would like to. It's a little far. Which is kind of, for me, everything at this point is kind of far. But yes, that is kind of far. So when we take our around the world cruise, we'll go to the Seychelles. Seychelles, site of one of the most boring episodes, boring challenges in all of Amazing Race history. That was, they basically had to run down the beach and couldn't leave. That was it. It's like, Seychelles, that's a beach. Wow, let's go. I mean, it's really pretty. They've got, like, all this ecotourism and volcanoes and shit. You're right. That's so good. It's weird. It tastes like a combination of, like, Southeast Asian and Indian together. I love how it makes food look. Oh, yes, parsley. And I'm always used to parsley as a dressing. As a kid, I'd always see the parsley on the side of everything. I mean, in the 70s, that's what it was, you know. Sprig of parsley, and it was curly Italian parsley always. I mean, as opposed to flat parsley. Nowadays, I would never even touch curly parsley. There'd always be the sprig of Italian parsley, or curly parsley, next to everything. And it was like a joke, because no one ever ate it. And there's a joke going around saying, oh, it's the same thing that they use on every plate. They just reuse it. So, destroy all garnish, you know? And the idea was like to rip it all up to make sure they can't reuse it. It was a joke. But now it's funny that you never see that, you know, random sprig of parsley on things. So now it has definitely been over 10 minutes and now we should be home, which is a problem. Okay, let's go. Let's go the long way. Where are you? You need to be here. Food is going to go on the table and you're not here to eat it. That's a problem. Okay, he's here. Yay! Ah, it made me super thirsty though. Water, doctor. Okay, what I'm gonna do is, he really wants it all on the same plate, but I can't see doing that. I'm gonna put the salad in a separate plate, and if he doesn't like it, that's just too bad. Because I don't like the idea of hot stuff and cold stuff on the same plate. In the avocado salad, the piece of avocado are too big, and I don't think it would really fit on the plate.
So, once more, the avocado salad that was once supposed to be green papaya salad, that was supposed to be a baby octopus salad, which is supposed to be a regular octopus salad, is now an avocado salad. Tick-tock, tick-tock. Made with Florida avocado. And tasted really good. So I did taste it earlier. So here we go. Here. Okay. Whoop-a-doo. It tasted really good. I mean, I'm glad I made the choice to do it. I should taste it again, shouldn't I? Now that it's not as cold. That will be leftovers. Maybe I'll do that. Avajo 21, thank you. Hey, shout out. Shout out to Avajo 21. Ava Jolie. Hello, shout out to you. Hope you are having a lovely evening as we eat our avocado salad. Yummy. Here, have a piece. Yummy for you. You like, you know? Mmm, that's quite tasty. You're welcome. That is quite tasty. I'll have to put it in a smaller bowl. But that works. Surprise! To all the people of the Seychelles, I apologize for creating my own dish based on yours. I don't usually do that. Today's your birthday. So how old are you? You brought up your birthday. Is it 21? Are you 22 now? Let us find out. Let's all find out. Ava Jolie. It's her birthday. Hey, we can actually sing. You're 13? Wow, that is super cool. You're a teenager now. Yay. Almost done, yes. Happy birthday. We can all sing happy birthday now because it's public domain. Happy birthday, dear Ava Jolie. Happy birthday to you. My throat won't let me sing it higher. Plus, I never liked the song. Ah, finally. Dinner time. Herbert Andy, thank you for liking the restream. Hello. Yes, it is dinner time. So, move quickly. If at all possible. I don't want to scoop with this. Can I get a camo? Oh no, I'm sorry, not now. We're in the middle of plating. If you come sometime during prep, when I'm cutting things up, that would be a really great time for a cameo. Because then I've got like nothing to do. So remember that next time. And happy birthday. That's really cool. I remember turning 13. My dad was chasing me around going, I've got a teenager in the house, oh no. So good for you. Yeah. Jeez, I want to use this all up.
Ow.
I'm gonna use it all up.
Yeah. Use it up and wear it out.
Use it up and wear it out. Who is that in the back? That is my husband, who just got home. And now we plate. Tammy, thank you for liking the restream. We plate our fish curry. Is very brown. Oh, I have to remember to dress the fish with the parsley. Hi! She says hi. Ava Jolie says hi. It's her birthday. She's 13 today. Say hello.
Hello.
He's putting away bananas.
This is really tasty. The fish kind of held together. And I'm sure the curry goes really well. Tammy, day. Ayo, Lydia! No, where are we here? Lydia was here earlier. Oh, that's Yolanda. Hey, Yolanda. Good seeing you. We have got our three dishes. One is sort of leftovers from Sunday. I don't want to waste an ounce of this because it's so tasty. Okay, on to the stove. So we have, and we're going to dress with parsley. When is your next stream? I'm thinking Thursday. We're definitely doing it next Tuesday. But I think on Thursday we might do it. So let me dress with the parsley. Now, it didn't say anything about dressing the other thing with the parsley. Oh, that looks quite nice. Yes, it does. Looks a little like what we did on Sunday. They are not far from India, but near to Africa. Yes, they are off the coast of sort of like Kenya and then Madagascar, and there are the islands there near Comoros and Mauritius, and they grow a lot of vanilla.
Excuse me. Oh, go ahead.
No, you.
All we need is forks?
Correct. Okay, let me get my picture for my blog because I always forget. And when I forget, that's a bad thing. And the salad. Okay, so can you follow me on Twitter? I think I already do, Ava Marie. Ava Jolie, rather. I think I already do. Everybody's saying hello. Okay, here's the deal. This is Seychelles Night 2. We've reached the end of Seychelles. So we have our two dishes. One that was supposed to be an avocado salad, which became a baby avocado salad, which became a green papaya salad, which abracadabra turned into an avocado salad. He doesn't like the camera. No, I'm the camera hog here. Pete's here. I've been working on book and store all day. Ah, well, enjoy your pizza. We're having pizza tomorrow. We have all these spices we can put on pizzas, too. Okay, so that salad had turned into an avocado salad. Thank you, Ray, for the follow. So here is our salad. Get white balance to figure itself out. There. And we have our Seychelles fish curry here with the great masala mix, which is to die for. It is the greatest spice mix. Yeah, I love it. And then our leftovers of our Creole rice that we made on Sunday. So that is Seychelles Night 2. Thank you for following. Tune in probably on Thursday for Night 1 of Sierra Leone. We'll be doing two nights, maybe three next week, of Sierra Leone. We'll definitely be doing next Tuesday. That's 100%. Pizza! So, thank you for coming by. You guys are super cool. Love y'all. Thank you for the compliments, everybody, Jonesy, Tammy, etc. Follow here on Meerkat, follow on Twitter, on Facebook, on Tumblr, on Instagram, on Pinterest, now on YouTube. Thank you, Tammy. So look for you next time. Look for the blog at Cliffyland tomorrow, cliffyland.com, with all the information about Seychelles and pictures and how this all went. Thank you, Carrie. Thank you, Tammy. Thank you, everybody. You guys are the coolest. You're the ginchiest. Love you. Thanks, and bye. We gotta go eat.